As curtains came down in the 55 capitals on the African continent, including the African Union headquarters in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, we managed to catch up with the acting foreign minister in international trade, Professor Emon Murwira, who walks us through on the deliberations which took place over the past 2 days.
The main issues that came there were mainly to focus with the restructuring of the AU. It was presented by President Kagame, and resolutions were adopted towards making sure that the AU, all commissioners, are appointed on merit, and that the AU should be streamlined and it should have financial frugality. And also, there was a focus on the COVID pandemic. This was being led by President Matamera Cyril Ramaphosa, and the issue there was basically to look at the work, the way Africa has responded to COVID-19. Although we are having a lot of problems, but it's amazing the way Africa has and has always overcome challenges. The issue is that in Africa, the COVID deaths are around 90,000, whereas in certain single countries, there are over 100,000 in the world. But the whole continent of Africa, with 1.4 billion people, with the perception of limited resources in terms of financial, you can see that Africa has more resources than what we can think about in terms of mental and its cohesion, the cohesion amongst its people. So you see that these were the two main issues that were looked at, and we believe that Africa is moving forward. We also looked at the issue of the election of the chairperson and vice chairperson, and as you know, the gender parity issue, and we have got Moussa Faki Mahamat retaining as the chairman and deputized by an honorable member from Rwanda, and the issues of our commissioners, of course, us technically, because Zambia and Angola had already occupied the positions for Southern Africa, the rest of the elections were not conducted. They were now, it was default that we were not going to go into an election anymore. Remember, we had our two candidates. We had Professor Tagwira for the Education, Innovation, Science and Technology. We also had Engineer Marawa, a very fantastic candidates. I think good brains for Africa. However, by technicality, elections couldn't proceed after the slots of Southern Africa were already occupied by Angola and Zambia, but we wish them well as well.
Focus on this issue, realizing that Zimbabwe will host the African Museum of Liberation.
We look at the theme that has been adopted as a way to ground Africa in itself for its own progress.
So you are happy it was a success?
Very big success. It has just been closed in the past minutes by President Tshisekedi, who reiterated the theme of this year and making sure that we move forward as Africa. And as usual, we adopted resolutions that include the resolution on the right to self-determination of the people of Palestine. We also talked about the resolution for the complete decolonization of Mauritius.
The Chagos Islands.
Yes, and we also talked about a resolution about the lifting of the embargo on Cuba, and Africa stands with Cuba.